Welcome RPA Champions, I am the RPA Champion and in this video you will learn how to make friends with automation. Now, to do so, we will be going to the Blue Prism World event, which is a virtual conference, and there we will be trying to make some friends. Obviously, we cannot connect with all of the great participants, RPA participants at the Blue Prism conference. Single-handedly, we will need the help of a Power Automate robot. Exactly, in today's video, you will learn how to create a Power Automate robot that is going to extract all of the participants at the conference, group them into Excel sheets, label the Excel sheets, and we will have Power Automate RPA friends from all over the world, even from Nepal. With RPA friends from all over the world, there is one question. If there is people in Nepal that are learning RPA, why are you not? With that question in mind, let's jump into this video. And before beginning to program, let's keep in mind the number one rule of automation. Know what we are automating.
You see, that's what you have to do. You have to use your mind.
So before we start building, this is the page that we are going to be automating. We are going to be going to this link, and this is the virtual conference. This is the list of all of the different participants. The participants are divided into different countries. Each country has a number of the different participants that are in that country. So we're going to be clicking on each one of these countries and extracting the data and putting it in Excel. All right, so now let's start building our bot. We're gonna start from a blank canvas, call this Blue Prism Automation. And this is going to be a version 2 because I have already created a few of these for this video. Now, with our blank canvas loading.
1 eternity later.
We are going to start by adding a launch Chrome instance. So this is going to be the easiest way of starting. So if we add the link of the page that we want to automate and make it maximized, we can start immediately with the recording. If we launch our robot, it's going to open the web page with that link. So now we are ready to start recording. Let's go back to Power Automate, click on the record button. This is going to allow us to capture very quickly all of the different elements on the page. So let's start by dragging in the recording and starting to record. So we have to click on the countries and we have to click on the different countries that are going to be on the list. Now, obviously, I'm not going to click on all of the different countries. I will just click on a few so that I can create a dynamic selector later on. I will click on the close all and also on the clear all. Now, with that, I have already gotten a few elements. Now let me also extract all of the countries that are here because we're going to create a loop that is going to go through all of these countries. So to do that, we just right click and extract on all. Now we have a basic skeleton for our recording and it hasn't been even a few minutes. So let's go over this and make it a little bit more readable. So by renaming the different spied elements, so by clicking F2, we can type in the name of the element that we want. So we are going to do this quickly for each one of the different elements. So it's going to be countries, and also this is going to be dynamic country. This is going to be the country that I'm going to be clicking on in a dynamic way. So United States, United Kingdom, India, Germany, and so forth. I will not rename the other ones, because all I need is the selector from this one. This one is the close all, and this one is clear all. With this, we have all of our selectors renamed, and it's going to be much easier to work with Power Automate. Well, not much easier, but it's just going to be transparent and clear and easy to understand. All right, let's remove also the buttons that we don't need. And as we can see, we just have 5, 6 steps so far. So it's very easy, nothing complicated or hard, but it's going to allow us to save a lot of time. And keep in mind that this is just an example that you can use on any web page. All right, so let's make sure that we have extracted all of the different countries. So we are going to be extracting all of the different countries. So in our process, we have dragged it to the top, and we are going to be clicking on the countries and extracting this, putting it into a variable called list of countries. In this way, it's going to be also easy for us to understand where this data is going to be stored. So what that action is going to do is going to extract all of the countries, put them into a list of variables, and then we can use this list of variables for a loop or for putting it in Excel. In our case, we're going to put it in a loop, but we'll see in a second how to do that. All right, so let's test our process. It has opened everything. And now if we go back to Power Automate and click on the list of countries, we see that we have all of the different countries inside of the list. So it has managed to work so far. It has encountered an error in the end, but it's not very important right now. So we can just delete it and come back to it later if we need it. So what we are going to be doing now is creating a loop. Why do we need a loop? Because we are going to be extracting the data from every single country that is in the list. So we have all of the different countries from United States to Nepal, and we want to extract the participants from each one of these countries. Now let's create a copy of the different elements that we also have in our page. So in the top part of the process, what we are going to do is we are going to click on the country list and extract this country list into a list of countries, close this, and then we are going to start with our loop. So in our loop, we are going to click on the countries. We are going to then click on the dynamic country and extract all of the participants. Now let's extract all of the data of the participants. And in my example here, the resolution is a little bit slightly off. So therefore you see the red boxes not exactly aligned with the elements on the page. Now to extract things is very easy. We just copied and pasted the extract data from web page, and now we are right clicking in the different elements and selecting what we want to extract. In our selectors, once we're done, we click save, and we're gonna save this data into an Excel sheet. So just by selecting the dropdown, there is no coding required. We are going to have this data in an Excel sheet that is available for us. Now we're gonna save this Excel sheet. We are going to save it as, because we want to save it to a specific folder and make sure that has the name, correct name as we want it. So in our example, I have already prepared the folder and the path. So it is going to go to the list of countries and to the selector. Now, I haven't created the variable called selector, so that's why it's giving me this error. We are going to create this variable in a second. Let's just close the Excel file. Now we have finished everything inside of our loop. It is going pretty smooth and fast. The process is taking shape. The last thing we have to do is create a variable. This variable is going to be used by our dynamic list of countries. We are going to set this variable to 1 and call it selector. Now we don't have the issue anymore in our Excel file. So that is excellent. Now the next thing that I have to do is I have to create a selector, a dynamic selector in our loop that is going to click on every country. So it's going to first click on the United States, then on India, then the United Kingdom, then on Germany, then on France, and so forth. Now to do that, our selector currently is just going to be clicking on the one dynamic country, meaning on that country that we have spied. To change the way that it's going to be clicking, since it's inside of a loop, we need to first test our process and make sure that it works until here. So what it should do, it should extract all of the list of countries and start clicking on the different elements. Now, in this example, it has encountered an error, but it has extracted the data and put it into the Excel sheet. Now, if we go back to Power Automate and see what the issue is, we will see that there is no issue. I have just put a breakpoint. All right. So far the process has worked. We have the list of all of the different countries. We also have all of different variables, the current variable in which the loop is, and that is pretty much it. We don't have to test this anymore. What we should do right now is we should finalize our process and make it click on every single country. So it's going to click on every single country, and then it's going to extract the participants from each one of those countries, save them in an Excel sheet. Now, to do that, we need to change this selector. So let's look at a couple of selectors. This is the selector, the next selector that I have spied in the beginning. We can see that the only element that is changing is in the end is the number. So from one, from zero, it goes to one, two, three. Now, if I change this into selector, this is going to become dynamic. And what that means is that with every cycle of the loop, it's going to click on the number that I put inside of the selector variable. Currently, the selector variable is set to one. So in that case, it's always going to click on element one. For every cycle of the loop, it's going to click on element one. But when I add the increase variable, this is going to add whatever I want to my selector variable. What does that mean? It's going to add one to the variable that I set to one. So it's going to become two at the end of my loop. With the next loop for the next country, it's going to be three. With the next loop for the next country, it's going to be four, and so forth. So now I just have to spy the clear all button to remove any filters, and that is everything I have to do in the process. Now I have some resolution issues, so that's why you might see the red light blinking. Let's clean this up. Let's remove all of the unnecessary things that the element spied, and let's rename our button to clear all. Now clear all, I apparently have it already, so I will not rename it. I will use the one that I have already created. So let's change this last step in our process, and let's add the one that was previously spied. Now let's move this inside of the loop so that it's going to clear the search results at the end of every loop. And let's run our process from the beginning. Now with this, we should also go into our folder where the files are going to be saved and remove all the files that we have. Now, if we run this, the process is just going to run from the beginning, and it will extract all of the countries, put the countries in Excel sheet, create a loop, and then go through each one of those countries. Now we have an issue here. So the process is not going forward. So therefore it had an issue in Power Automate. If we go back to Power Automate, we can see exactly what the issue is. The issue is that the Power Automate could not find this element on the page. So let's just try the other element that I have and see if like that is going to work. Let's run our process again and see if this time it's going to run from the beginning until the end. So what we should be doing, it should go to the page of every single country and extract the participants from that page, save the participants into an Excel sheet, and label the Excel sheet with the country and the number of participants. So we can see that it's working. It's generating the different Excel sheets. It is also going through the different pages, removing the filters, and everything seems to be working as it should be. However, one observation, as you can see, there is only 40 something participants. There is more participants per page. So this is happening because the extraction that we have built. So let's pause this process right here. And if we take a look at the extraction that we have built, the extraction is only taking away the first page that it has. There is no pagination. So if we open an Excel sheet that I have here, it extracts only 40 participants. So we want to extract all of the participants. So what do you think we should do? How can this be done? It can be done in different ways. How I have done it, I have just sent some key items, like the down key, to the process. So this is going to move the page down and refresh all of the elements. So if we open one of the files that I have extracted previously, we can see that we have all of the different participants. There is other ways that this can be done. I leave it to you to discover any other way. I hope you have enjoyed this video, that you have learned a lot of things, and that you are ready to take Power Automate and learn more new things about Power Automate. Give yourself, as always, a high five for watching Power Automate, for learning and becoming another RPA champion. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.